That tafsir is a hadith, very beautiful hadith. Inna li kulli shay'in sharafa. For everything that is certain dignity and honor. Wa inna ashrafa al majalisi mastuqbila bihi al qibla. The most honored situation you are in when you are facing the qibla. Like we are doing right now. Alhamdulillah, that's one of the best situations you are in. And then وَمَنْ أَحَبَّ أَنْ يَكُونَ أَعَزَّ النَّاسِ فَلْيَتَّقِ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ أَحَبَّ أَنْ يَكُونَ أَقْوَى النَّاسِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَمَنْ أَحَبَّ أَنْ يَكُونَ أَغْنَى النَّاسِ فَلْيَكُنْ بِمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَوْفَقُ مِمَّا عِنْدَ غَيْرِهِ. So my talk today is about a very, very simple but basic issue. Let us start by saying that everything in this universe, or every action, has a start and has an end. Right? You got from home, took one step and then walked till you need to reach the masjid. Our khutbah today will have a start and have an end. Everything. And it has been stated in the Chinese proverb that tariq al-alf mil yabda'u bi khutbah. A way, if you are going to take the road, trip, 1,000 miles, start with a step, the first step. Our first step should be always Bismillah. My talk today is about Bismillah. We start with Al-Fatiha, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, and this is the most beautiful verse that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed for us to worship Him with His words, Bismillah. This word, I wanted every person to take it as your start in any action. In any action you do in this life, say Bismillah. If you wanted to eat, say Bismillah. If you wanted to walk out, Bismillah. And if you wanted to do any action in your life, to go to bed, Bismillah, Allahumma ta'atu jambi wa bismika arfa'u, Bismillah. When you wake up, Alhamdulillah, Bismillah. If you wanted to, this is very interesting. Between Bismillah and Alhamdulillah should be your life. Any action in your life, try to put it in a bracket, Bismillah, you start with, and Alhamdulillah. If you want to take medicine, say Bismillah. If you want to slaughter, to eat, Bismillah. If you wanted to do husband-wife relationship, Bismillah. Always Bismillah come in the positive sense. You cannot do Bismillah, or you cannot say Bismillah and then commit an evil action. It doesn't work, it doesn't fit, right? So make all your life anything started by Bismillah. And the Prophet has told us, any action you do without Bismillah, فهو أبطر. It's not complete. It's not right. The very, very, very first surah revealed in the Quran, what was it? اقرأ بسم ربك. اقرأ بسم ربك. By the name of Allah. So any action in this life, make it by the name of Allah. Allah, Bismillah. Allah, everything is worshiping Allah. Everything is paying praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything in the whole universe. The humans are the ones who are not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored us as humans. And before we have been created, Allah has created the universe for us. So when Adam came from Jannah to be on earth, Allah made everything for him ready to receive this human, to be dignified. And all the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to sabbih Allah. Always paying praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, as I said, every action or all your actions in this life, make it in this frame. Bismillah, Alhamdulillah. One person came to that sheikh and asked him, is the cigarette haram or halal? Cigarette. It's not mentioned in the Quran. Are the pharmaceuticals which we are doing right now, industry, is mentioned in the Quran? No. The sheikh told him, see, before you smoke, do you say Bismillah? And after you finish, you say Alhamdulillah? You don't do that, huh? No, nobody does that. If you wanted to take a drug, yeah, cocaine, things like that, or any bad action, do you say Bismillah and then you say Alhamdulillah? No. So the word Bismillah and Alhamdulillah, always what in between is Ibadahillah, is something which is always in the goodness, doing good. Bismillah, we know that all the ancient, the Muslim scholars has done a lot, contributed a lot to the humanity, scientifically. They were excellent in so many areas. And you will find that any one of them was a person of Allah. He knows Allah and he uses his knowledge of Allah to do goodness. So you find that those who have invented, for example, the glasses, those who have worked in astronomy, were not scientists by pure means, but they were Muslims knowing Allah and working science and getting this science or utilizing this science for the goodness of humanity. So Bismillah is a word, before you take medicine, before you take your tablet as a medicine, you say Bismillah. Bismillah, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you shifa. But if you are smoking, you are not going to say Bismillah. And as Wahid bin al-Mashayikh said that a cigara, was asking about cigara, for example, he said, "Muntinatun lil fam," muntinatun lil fa, meaning that makes you smell bad. Muhlikatun lil mikhlal, taking drain into your mind, money. La tabda'u bismillah, wa la tantahi bilhamdulillah. So that's something wrong. So any aspect. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ya'lam sirra wa akhfa. He knows everything. And so you find that a lot of people come to the masjid, to the sheikh and ask him, oh, my friend is asking about so. You are asking about it, Allah knows about you. You can ask yourself, can I start at Bismillah and end it by Alhamdulillah? If it is, that's perfect. If not, then you know this is not halal, it's not right. So the Bismillah always get into the positive, nothing will be into the negative sense. Look here, for example, the TV, the programs, the discoveries right now, they have been using the ultrasound. Ultrasound by itself is something good. You can utilize ultrasound to heal, to break down, for example, stones in the gallbladder or kidney. It is something good. But when you use this, you are using Bismillah. But when you are using the sonars or the solar or the ultrasound in the ocean, and that's what the army is using, and killing the whales, you find that whales live in salty water. Sometimes they find it in San Francisco, in the sweet area. Why? They are escaping from the ultrasound waves. That is not used in Bismillah. It is used for an evil action. Laser. They use the laser, for example, to correct the vision. They use the laser to also break some of the stones and things like that. And this utilization is under the banner of Bismillah. But when you use the laser to guide missiles or drones to kill people and the humanity, it is not. No. The Prophet, when he asked the people to go for fight, say, "Ughzu Bismillah," in the name of Allah, meaning that all your actions should be good, starting Bismillah. Even in our life, if you are angry about somebody and want to talk to him, of course you forget to say Bismillah, right? But if you say Bismillah and you're going to talk to somebody, you will not talk evil. So what I was saying, that microwave, for example. Microwave, it's something good, we boil water on it. But the evil action, they can use the microwave right now, a big screen microwave, big area microwave, and direct it towards the people, will evaporate the water from your body. Evil action. So, as I said, between Bismillah and Alhamdulillah, that is all your life should be right now. Any action you do, say Bismillah. Why? Because Allah is the Creator. Allah is the Creator. And we are slaves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You like it or not, we are all slaves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah knows everything. يُسَبِّحُ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything is worshiping Allah. The day and the night also are worshiping Allah, are praising Allah, are appreciating the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَسْجُدُ لَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَالشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ وَالنُّجُومُ وَالْجِبَالُ وَالشَّجَرُ وَالدَّوَابُ وَكَثِيرٌ مِنَ النَّاسِ وَكَثِيرٌ حَقَّ عَلَيْهِ الْعَذَابُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, can you see that? To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything is prostrating. Allah خلق السماوات والأرض بالحق. He created for a purpose, heavens and earth, as well as we are created for a purpose. But we have always to be aware, and we have to be always directed to or focused on why we are created. So I was saying that Allah has ownership of everything. The word Allah in Arabic is a very beautiful word. You cannot make it double. You cannot make it double. Or many gods. But in Arabic, Allah, you cannot do that. The word Allah is pure for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah in Arabic is not a masculine or feminine. You cannot make it masculine or feminine. But in English, you can say ilah, you can do. Ilah is mudhakkar. But what I'm saying, Allah al-awwal al-akhir, this name is unique in its meaning and unique in its pronunciation. Allah is the only word in Arabic, Allah is the only word that you can use it for asking Allah by saying, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, or Allahumma, Allahumma. And in the Quran, the whole Quran, there is nothing called Ya Allah, but Allahumma. Allah is the only word in the Arabic language, the Arabic dictionary, that you can attach ta' al-qasam to it. And this has been mentioned in the Quran, Tallahi. You cannot say it to anyone. So the word Allah, if you go into which may inshallah later on talk about it, is unique word. There is no beginning, there is no end to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah knows everything. Allah owns everything. In this life, you have Malik, you have Malik. In this life, you have a Malik, Malik. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. We say, Malik Yawm al-Din, and some say, Malik Yawm al-Din. There is a king, and there is an owner. You might be a king, you might have a king, but the king does not own your property. You are the owner of your property, but he is the king. He has power over you. Or you might have an owner, but he is not a king. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the owner and is the sovereign of all the universe. He has control over everything. What Allah is going to do to you is going to happen, regardless. Whatever measures you take, whatever precautions you take. Everything is done by His authority. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always does the goodness for us. So we say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. As I was saying, Make it as a way of your life. And between Allah, between Bismillah and Alhamdulillah, make your actions. So, my message today to you is, if you know Allah, well, then you know the purpose of your life. We are here to have a purpose in the life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِعَبْدُ. All of the creation to worship Allah. And as I said, to worship Allah, make every action acceptable and make every action in a positive way, started by Bismillah and ended by Alhamdulillah Ar-Rahim. Then you fulfill very, very big attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the way Bismillah by itself is a good start. But when you say Bismillah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, then you are admitting or you are approaching Allah by His mercy, which is great mercy to us. And as I said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never do something wrong. Or I would say not wrong. Never do something which is bad to you. قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَلِكَ الْمُلْكِ تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءُ. And so on, so on, so on. And at the end they say, بِيَمْكَ الْخَيْرُ. What is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is doing for us is goodness for us. Even if we don't understand the meaning of it, we don't understand it right now, but maybe later on we can figure out that it's goodness for us. So my message today is so simple and so easy and so little but so magnificent at the same time. Start with Bismillah, any action, try to end it by Alhamdulillah. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد بقدر حبك فيه. اللهم جزيه عنا خير ما جزيت نبيا عن أمته. اللهم اغفر ذنوبنا واستر عيوبنا وفرج كروبنا واشرح صدورنا. رب آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. أو الله, help us to be on the right way. Oh Allah, unite our hearts together. Oh Allah, guide us to the right actions to do. Oh Allah, give speedy recovery to those who are sick. Oh Allah, give mercy and acceptance for those who died before us, Ya Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, forgive our sins. Oh Allah, help us to do goodness in this life as well as in the life to come. Oh Allah, help the Muslims over the world to understand the religion, to understand the actual meaning of the religion, and the actual meaning of submission to you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and unite their hearts and give them victory over those who are oppressing them. Oh Allah, whoever would like to do goodness for the Muslims, help him to do that. And whoever wanted to attack and do wrong to the Muslims, oh Allah, we leave them to you to punish them. Subhanaka Allahumma. Alhamdulillah. Oh Allah, forgive us, and oh Allah, help us. رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنٍ وَاجْعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا. أَخْوَةَ الْإِسْلَامِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِيتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَنَهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنكَرِ وَالْبَغْيِ يَعِظُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. وَقُومُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ يَرْحَمْنَا وَيَرْحَمْكُمُ اللَّهُ.